So your first magician promises to take you on a psychological journey, making you question your reality. From appearing on BBC to hosting and performing his repeatedly sold-out stage show, Influence, he is a rising star in the field of mentalism. Please welcome Dean Williamson.
Good day, everybody. Good day, America, and everybody watching around the world. Jonathon, if you could put me on spotlight, I think I am now. That's great. So I am going to need somebody to help me throughout these demonstrations. So just need one person to help me.
Absolutely.
Can you
slide
someone for me, Jonathon?
Let us choose Joanne McMillan. Joanne, I am going to go ahead and unmute you. Can you hear us?
Yes.
Perfect. Hi, Joanne, how are you?
Fine.
Great. Are you okay to help us?
Yes, okay.
Yeah. Perfect. It's okay if I can't see you as long as I can hear you and you can hear me. That's absolutely perfect. So I have the camera here so that everybody can see me at this moment in time, so that you can focus on me and on my words. I'm going to give you a little bit of an explanation in a moment, give you some context what you're about to experience. So some people say that life can be predictable. We say that events can be predictable, which means sometimes we can be predictable. Now, some people find predictability boring. I think there's a certain type of solace that you can find within it, a certain type of joy, you might say. Now, predictability relates to things like normality, regularity, uniformity. And I'm sure during the lockdown, we're all looking forward to getting back to some of that. So we're going to dig down into the joy of predictability. Let's see what happens. So, Joanne, thank you so much for helping me. Have you ever had the experience where you feel like you've known someone for years when you've just met them? You may have heard of somebody say that.
Yes.
Yeah? Okay. So the reason you would feel like with somebody you've just met is because you're of the same mindset. You're of similar thoughts. But it's only kind of further down the relationship, whether it might be a partner or a friend, when you can really truly analyse what that is. And it kind of comes to fruition in your mind. So I'm going to give you that experience now. So, Joanne, I have an envelope here. Okay. And you can see this?
Yes. Yes.
Perfect. So in this envelope, Joanne, I have some information that I've written down. Now, you know what this word is. Okay. And it's in your subconsciousness at the moment. We're going to bring it forward. So I'm going to give you some help, some tips to help you along the way. So Joanne, I just want you to think about going to your favourite place to eat or favourite restaurant at the end of the lockdown. I think you have somewhere in mind now. And think about the meal that you would most like to eat. Do you have something in mind now? Do you have something in mind? Can you still hear us, Joanne?
Yeah, it just kept going on and off a bit then.
That's okay. So if you're going to your favourite restaurant at the end of the lockdown, what would be the one thing that you would order? What would you be looking forward to eating most?
Chinese.
Chinese? Anything in particular?
King prawn, fried rice.
Nice, very specific. That's a really nice dish, I have to say. In fact, everybody else can kind of play along with this. Jonathon, if you could come up mute for a moment, and yes. what would you thought of? What are you looking forward to eating?
I am looking forward to eating a big cheeseburger, American cheeseburger.
Big cheeseburger. Interesting, but it shows how random it is, right? And it literally could be anything. But the strange thing is, Joanne, I did have a prediction in here, and you picked Chinese. And wouldn't it be crazy if I gave you that experience of we're of the same mindset now, because I also know Chinese. Okay, so I'm going to bring the camera down so you can see my table here. Perfect. I'm going to move back a moment. There we go. Perfect. So, Joanne, I believe that everybody has this kind of ingrained sense of predictability. So think about if you're watching a film, sometimes you can predict the ending, especially if it's a little boring, that, you know, the kind of the plot twists aren't very good, and you can kind of predict the ending for that. If you're a sports fan, you know, probably you can probably predict whether your team's going to win or lose, dependent on the form. And if there's any office workers listening in now, if you've got a colleague that you or a co-worker that you don't like, you can probably predict that they're going to annoy you at some point. So we have this kind of inbuilt predictability. So, Joanne, if I was to say to you, I have a picture of a shape in my pocket, it's just a simple shape, what's the first thing that will come to your mind?
Triangle.
Triangle. Well, I had a picture of a triangle in my pocket. I could, you know, I wasn't really fair because I thought I'd hedge my bets, because in this pocket I had a picture of a circle, in this pocket I had a picture of a square, and in this pocket I had a picture of a star. Now, sometimes people go a little left field with this, and just in case I had a picture of a dodecahedron overhead. So just remind us, what was your shape, Joanne?
Triangle.
Triangle, okay. And your prediction was correct that I'd have a triangle. But I knew you were going to say that, and I actually predicted before the show that your prediction would be a triangle. A little bit confusing, but I'll show you why. Because if we look at the back of these shapes, they're blank. Nothing interesting there. But if I really had some evidence and predicted that you would pick the triangle, I would probably write a message like this on the back, which says, you will choose this shape, and that is on the back of the triangle. Excellent prediction skills, Jerome. Thank you very much. Perfect. So, everything that we've seen so far, Joanne, are you still okay to help us? You're still okay to stay on the line? Is that right? Perfect. Thank you so much. So everything we've seen so far has been a little concealed. There's kind of things been hidden in envelopes, pockets, things like that. I want to make it as fair as possible this time. So we're going to lay out and look at everything before we go down this path. Because it's interesting with predictability. Sometimes you don't know what the end result is going to be because you've not seen all the segments along the way. But what about if you see everything along the way, and your destination still matches the prediction? So in my wallet here, I'll be honest, I have this prediction here. Okay, now we're still going to use some shapes, but these are slightly different. So we have a circle, a square, wavy lines, cross, and the star. Now, I'm unsure if you're familiar with these shapes or not. I know there's magicians watching, so they will know these. These are called ESP symbols, which stands for extrasensory perception. And coincidentally, they were came about in the 1920s America, somewhere about 100 years ago, to test the things like clairvoyancy, second sight, telepathy, general psychic ability. So, Joanne, we're going to start eliminating these shapes, okay? We're going to end up with one. So could you pick one of these shapes for me now to eliminate?
Square.
Square. Okay. Four left. Can you pick another one?
The plus sign.
Plus sign, the cross. We have this wavy lines, a circle, and the star. Can you pick one?
Circle.
Circle. And finally, so a big decision now, Joanne. Do you want to eliminate the wavy lines or the star?
Star.
Star. Leaving the wavy lines?
Yeah.
Perfect. Okay. So it's interesting that you picked the wavy lines. This is an unusual one to pick. Not many people pick this. And I'm glad you picked this one, Joanne. It shows that you are, I would say, quite unpredictable. But I said I had a prediction over here in my wallet. Wouldn't it be incredible, even though everything was laid out on the table in full view, you made all the choices, you still match my prediction with the wavy lines. Wonderful. Okay, so I'm going to show you one more demonstration before we do something really random. Now, I know this is a bit of a magic show, and what I do is very different to what you're going to see later on, but I thought I'd bring something, the closest connecting thing that I could do with magic, which is a deck of playing cards. I also have a prediction over here, which we're going to leave in full view. Now, Joanne, I'm going to give you one of two options. I can deal these cards down onto the table like this, or you can give me a number now to deal to. So would you like me to deal cards one at a time? So would you like me to deal, or do you want to pick a number now?
I'll give you a number.
Okay, what's the number? What, between 1 and 52?
31.
31, okay, we're going to have to deal 31 cards, that's fine. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10,
11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. If there's magicians watching, there's no bottom deals. 29, 30, and it was 31, yes?
Yeah.
31, right there. Okay, that's kind of just messed up a little bit. Now, my prediction was that you would stop here. No, really, the prediction was you will stop. Not that impressive a note. If we open up the prediction, there is a message inside here which says, can you read that out for me?
At the Nine of Hearts.
At the Nine of Hearts.
Bear with me, my computer is just locked at the completely wrong time. Okay, you can still see me, Joanne?
Yeah.
Love, you can see my jeans at this moment in time. Bear with me. There we go. We're back on the screen. Perfect. Okay. So, Joanne, the interesting thing is, if you'd have gone with card number 30, it would have been blank. If you'd gone with card 32, that would have been blank as well. In fact, if you'd have stopped me, gave me any other number, we'll see that the rest of the cards are all blank. And that is the joy of predictability. Thank you very much, Joanne. So I'm going to show you guys something else. Now we need to have the yin to the yang of predictability. If that makes sense. Because whilst it's good and hopefully we've seen the joy in predictability and how it can be really interesting, they say variety is the spice of life. So let's do something that's random. So Joanne, you can go back on mute now. Thank you so much for helping me. I really appreciate your help with this. Thank you very much. This is a perception test. I'm going to see how far down the rabbit hole I can really take you. Now, I want you all to focus on this card. This is the black 10 of spades. Notice how different it is from all the other cards I'm laying down onto the table. Now, you may well have already noticed the biggest difference of all, which is that of the colour. Notice how much this black 10 contrasts from all the other cards on the table. I'm going to leave that there for a moment, and I want you to burn that image into your mind. Let's begin. Now, if I take this card and place it into the others, please notice the position of that black 10. Now, you would swear that that card was second from top, unless it still is back at the top. I'll do it again nice and slow this time. We place the 10 into the other cards. And again, you would swear that that card was in the other cards, maybe second from top, unless it is back at the top again. Now, we can go a lot further with this, a lot deeper, in fact. So deep that your perception right now is that I'm placing this 10 to the bottom of the cards. Or did I? Because that black 10's back at the top again. Now I'm going to try something different. I'm going to attempt to get the black 10 to jump from over there into these red cards here. And this happens in 3, 2, 1. Just like that. See, perception is a really interesting thing. Because as you were looking through each of these cards, the spot where that black 10 was, and you noticed it jumping from place to place, and you were watching it really eager-eyed to spot me and catch me out, you may begin to wonder if I had a black 10 at all. Did I ever take it out of the box? Perception's a strange thing. Thank you very much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Dean Williamson. I'm a mind reader from the UK. I hope to see you all again soon. Stay safe, everybody.
Wow. Speechless. Yes, please show your love for Dean Williamson.